ICC is really happy with all of you and to organize. The conference becomes more special because of the presence of acts like the Chief Executive Officer of the state. He has a vision. Agriculture is another important. Empower the farmers, give them access to the best of seeds, technologies, and link them up with the markets. With these objectives, the issues and the solutions for the various problems and challenges which the rice fraternity is facing in the state.
That includes India. Today, globally, rice is produced 660 million metric tons. By 2030, we need to produce 770 million metric tons. India from 110 million metric tons to 130 million metric tons. That is more than 35% more rice need to be produced within these limited resources available to us. The themes of this particular 2 days rice conclave would include or would discuss on quality seed production, distribution, government schemes, available technologies, and its modernization. Whenever I say the word modernization, it very much relates to our Honorable Chief Minister. Since he is in the state or in the country's politics, he always emphasized the new science and technology and its intervention and utilization for modernization in agriculture as well as in IT sector. Now, one more thing is very important is marketing. Unless we connect to the national and international market, farmers, what they produce, if they cannot sell or if they do not get right price, the entire exercise becomes futile. And the marketing is also important, sir. At the same time, we need to connect with real-time agriculture growth. We must know that what is needed in the country, in the state, as well as what is the scenario, global scenario in the world. If we do not know the world scenario, what is the status of rice production across the country, across the world, we would not be able to produce that type of rice and to be marketed. So the real-time agriculture growth is also a very important point to this. As our Honorable Prime Minister declared that next 5 years we need to double the agriculture farm income, farmers' income. How do you get the farmers' income double unless farmers, what they produce, they get the right minimum support price as well as connected with the market and its availability. So all these things, the technology as well as dissemination of the schemes are very much integrated. Now the last part that what I would like to mention here as very limited time, I have seen, sir, many countries, wherever they produce something, they demonstrate it. There is a model farm. In Myanmar, there is a precedent model farm of agriculture. Myself and Swaminathan, together we went there, and 10,000 of people every day, they come to see that model farm. Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore, 100 years back, told us, we need a model village. Sir, we haven't yet achieved that model village. We haven't yet achieved that kind of model farm. So probably with your dynamic leadership, Andhra Pradesh can lead in this dimension to have a model modern farm, and where stakeholders of marketing, stakeholders of scientists, stakeholders of farmers can come, see, and take the lessons what need to translate to his own farm. We need a model farm to grow and to lead the future of the state as well as for the country. Thank you very much. Well,
Chief Minister, to please address us.
Yusuf Bharati University, Professor Sopan Kumar Datta, Special Chief Secretary, Department of Agriculture and Cooperation, Government of Andhra Pradesh, Sri B. Rajasekhar, వైస్ ఛాన్సలర్ ఆంధ్ర ఆచార్య ఎన్జిఆర్ రంగా అగ్రికల్చర్ యూనివర్సిటీ మిస్టర్ దామోదర్ నాయుడు, స్పెషల్ కమిషనర్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ కోఆపరేషన్ శ్రీ హరి జవహర్ లాల్, అండ్ రెస్పెక్టెడ్ డెలిగేట్స్ అండ్ ప్రోగ్రెసివ్ ఫార్మర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, ఐ ఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ. రీసెంట్లీ వీ హ్యాడ్ ఏపీ అగ్రిటెక్ 2017 విశాఖపట్నం. ఈవెన్ డే బిఫోర్ ఎస్టర్డే ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ వీ హ్యాడ్ ఎ డీటెయిల్డ్ డిస్కషన్ ఇన్ ది అసెంబ్లీ అబౌట్ అగ్రికల్చర్, ఫ్యూచర్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రికల్చర్. టుడే ఐఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ అగైన్. ఇండియా రైస్ కాన్క్లేవ్ 2017 ఈజ్ బీయింగ్ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ విజయవాడ. ఐఎమ్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ ఫర్ దట్. యు సీ హియర్ ఇన్ ఇండియా ప్యాడీ ఆక్యుపైస్ ది ఫస్ట్ ప్లేస్ బోత్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఏరియా అండ్ ఆల్సో ప్రొడక్షన్. దిస్ రైస్ ప్రొడక్షన్ ఇన్ ది కంట్రీ ఈజ్ పాసింగ్ త్రూ సీరియస్ కన్స్ట్రైంట్స్ లైక్ ఈల్డ్, వాటర్ స్కార్సిటీ, డ్రౌట్, ఇంక్రీజ్డ్ యూజ్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రో ఇంపోర్ట్స్, ఇర్రెగ్యులర్ మాన్సూన్, ఇంక్రీజింగ్ సాయిల్ మినరల్ స్ట్రెస్, ఫ్లాష్ ఫ్లడ్స్, వాటర్ లాగింగ్, హై కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ కల్టివేషన్, లేబర్ స్కార్సిటీ, ఇన్అడెక్వేట్ స్టోరేజ్ ఫెసిలిటీస్, ఇన్వేజివ్ పెస్ట్ అండ్ డిసీజ్, ల్యాక్ ఆఫ్ పాలసీ ఇన్నోవేషన్స్ అండ్ ఇన్అడెక్వేట్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషనల్ డైనమిక్స్. We need to focus on proper utilization of resources in diverse agroclimatic zones in the country by providing quality seed, developing high-yielding varieties, hybrid rice, effective natural resource management, developing strategies on biotic and abiotic stress management, cost-effective mechanization, and promoting agriculture stewardship. ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఈజ్ అన్ అగ్రికల్చరల్ డెవలప్డ్ స్టేట్ విత్ నియర్లీ 27.5% ఆఫ్ ది జిఎస్డిపి కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది అగ్రికల్చర్ సెక్టర్, ఎంప్లాయింగ్ అబౌట్ 62% ది సెక్టర్. ది అగ్రికల్చర్ సెక్టర్ ఎంప్లాయీస్ అరౌండ్ 60% ఆఫ్ ది మెయిన్ వర్క్ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టేట్ అండ్ 76% ఆఫ్ ది మార్జినల్ వర్క్ ఫోర్స్, దస్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ to be the largest employment generating sector among states. Andhra Pradesh is one of the leading producers of paddy in the country. Nearly one third of the total area, that is 23 lakh hectares, is under paddy cultivation in Andhra Pradesh. This contributes to nearly 66% of the total food grain production in the state. Andhra Pradesh state is second in terms of productivity, that is 5,998 kgs per hectare, after Punjab 6,000 kgs per hectare in the country. All India productivity is 2,404 kgs per hectare only. Though the productivity of the state is second highest in the country, there is a vast difference in productivity levels across different agroclimatic zones. For example, నార్త్ కోస్టల్ జోన్ కంప్రైజింగ్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీకాకుళం, విజయనగరం, విశాఖపట్నం డిస్టేట్స్ రికార్డ్ ఓన్లీ 2,200 కేజీస్ ఫర్ హెక్టార్. ఇన్ మ్యాక్సిమం ప్రొడక్టివిటీ డిస్టేట్స్ ఆల్సో దెర్ ఆర్ సర్టన్ పాకెట్స్ రికార్డింగ్ లెస్సర్ రీడ్స్ దెన్ ది స్టేట్ ఆవరేజ్. ది ఏరియా ఆఫ్ ప్యాడీ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో నాట్ స్టెబిలైజ్డ్ డ్యూ టు డీవియేషన్ రెయిన్ఫాల్, but there is constant increase in productivity. Andhra Pradesh is known for its rich diversity of rice varieties. Medium to long duration, 120 to 170 days, varieties are grown in the state. During 2016-17, 4.4 lakh hectares of paddy crop area was saved, sustained through the release of water from Pattisima and Pulichintala project, which also fetched highest yields. Here, I wanted to say, we had two rivers. One is Godavari, another is Krishna River. It is there for decades together. But first time, within a year time, we are able to link these two rivers. This is the first of its kind in India, interlinking of rivers. Thereby, as on today, around 104 TMC of water we got from Godavari to Krishna. What you are seeing in Krishna, this is the water we brought from Godavari. That is how we are able to cultivate extremely well in Andhra Pradesh. That is a time, it is a history, it is a record time we are able to complete it. Even if you see, variety plays a major role in increasing the productivity and maintaining sustainable production. The varieties developed in Andhra Pradesh are very popular throughout the country and occupying 25% of the total area. There is a need to develop new varieties to specific agroclimatic zones, which includes both biotic and abiotic stresses. Andhra Pradesh is developing 5 crop agri zones and paddy is one among them. The paddy crop zone is subdivided into 4 sub-zones. The aim is to increase the farm income by adopting appropriate cropping sequence, suitable varieties, high production and low cost techniques. I expect this rice conclave will come up with suitable recommendations. With a vision to develop Andhra Pradesh as a global seeds hub, recently I am very happy to inform you, we are working with Iowa. Andhra Pradesh is the best place for seed production. From Kurnool, even different areas, different seed we can produce here. That's why we want to set up mega seed park in Kurnool. Even Iowa is working with us. This is the first of its kind in India. Ultimately, I wanted to produce seed not only for Andhra Pradesh, for India, ultimately for Southeast Asia. I am inviting all companies all over the world to come and set up their operations in Andhra Pradesh. We are prepared to extend all the cooperation. We are going to build the best infrastructure. And also, rice value chain. If I wanted to, if you see in Andhra Pradesh at present, the annual paddy production is around 120 lakh metric tons in the state. The state consumption is around 80 to 90 lakh metric tons. Remaining there is a surplus. As an, you are all aware, Andhra Pradesh is known very well, rice bowl of India. Even when there was food shortage, we used to give food for the country, especially southern parts. And also if you can compare rice produced in other parts in Andhra Pradesh, always Andhra rice is preferable, one of the best variety. That is why there is a lot of demand Andhra rice from the beginning. Here I wanted to request all of you. All scientists are here. I am concentrating as on today in a big way. How to increase the productivity, how to reduce the cost, and also how to go about better varieties also. If you see in China, they are able to produce nearly 8,000 kgs per hectare. World average is less. In India, it is only 2,440. Andhra Pradesh, 5,190. Punjab is 6,000. So here, what I wanted to request all of you, how to increase the productivity. If China is doing 8,000 kgs per hectare, why can't we plan like that? Now, mechanization is not a big problem. Even small holdings, Japan is very popular for mechanization. Even you can use all machines available, and also you can go total mechanization now. This you can innovate. Thereby, how to improve the quality? We are doing extremely well in soil testing. Every year, 100% last year, we were able to go for soil testing. On the base of the profile of the soil, we have added micronutrients. My government has taken a decision free supply of micronutrients irrespective of farmers, either big or small, with a saturation mode. Now, because of that, it has given excellent advantage for us. Now we want to go in agriculture, uberization, all equipment is available. We wanted to use agriculture equipment with 90% or 80% efficiency, and also all inputs online. Farmer will touch computer one button, kiosk, or by cell phone. He must be in a position to order what all he needs. And also drones have come for pest detection, soil testing, and also how to apply pest also. Pest control, how to spray, all these things just come. Now if you see, this type of best practice are coming. Now I ask my people to prepare how to engage all these people. They are having best practices as on today. By using the services of private people also in agriculture, and also government will do research and coordination facilitation role, how to achieve the best in the world. That is the exercise we are working. I wanted to bring knowledge available all over the world. Here local scientists are here. You have to work in the direction that technology, that knowledge, how to apply to our suitable conditions. It may be sometimes there are different agrarian zones. Sometimes there are some external factors will apply. That is where scientist has to apply your knowledge and also innovate in such a way how to get the best. I am very clear, anywhere in the world, people are safe. Nowhere, compared to our scientists, our farmers, they are not superior. Only one thing, over a period of time, they are able to implement all these things. They made it, they prepared one of the best infrastructure, and also they developed one of the best knowledge. They are using technology and mechanization in a big way. That's why they are able to achieve this type of development. In agriculture, as on today, if you see all of us, thanks to Swaminathan, there is a green revolution. We are able to achieve food security. Now, we are able to achieve food security, we are unable to provide farmer security. This is the need of the hour. Agriculture has to think just like business. Everybody, we are all working for the livelihood. Even employees or business people or anybody for that matter, everybody is working for livelihood and also career. But farmer is having the problem. If you do agriculture, always it is on, sometimes on nature. Either drought, or otherwise floods, or otherwise pest, or otherwise there is no market, there is no demand in the market. This is the scenario. Now, thanks to technology, we have to integrate everything. This is where this conference, I am requesting all of you on rice. After Gujarat, Punjab, Andhra Pradesh is the second largest production and also productivity, and also highest cultivation agriculture. What I want to request all of you, take the data available from Andhra Pradesh. From there onwards, you have to guide us. If you do like this, then productivity will increase and preferable varieties will come. Thereby, there is a good demand. And also, you have to go for value addition also. One is, how we have to cultivate the varieties and also best practices in agrarian. What are the best practices you can follow? As on today, 2 years back or 3 years back, 2014 before, in Andhra Pradesh we had so many problems. There was no proper seed. Even fertilizer shortage. Even adulteration of pesticides. Even there is no power. Even midnight, 2 o'clock, farmers used to wait. And also irregular maintenance of power. So many farmers were dead because of short circuit or electrical shocks. That were the order of the days. Even people used to wait in police station for getting 1 or 2 bags of fertilizer. So today, all these problems we are able to overcome now. Daytime power I can supply. Whenever there is a need, we can give adequate power. Seed, there is no problem. We are using biometrics. And also fertilizer, there is no problem. As a matter of fact, now we are reducing the consumption of fertilizer. And also pesticides. Today I asked my special chief secretary, to work it out. Why can't we apply drones? First of all, on paddy. Our main paddy is, if you see, East Godavari, West Godavari, Krishna, Guntur. These are all 2 deltas, majority of the crop. And also if you see here, if you can collect data, historical data on pest, so that you will have an idea when pest has come, what is the prevalence, and also if you can watch through satellite, through drones, there is a Pantix app. Anybody want to test at any time, I can test. All this data, if you can use it, then you have to go for preventive. Not applying pest in a big way. Ultimately, we have to use it whenever there is a necessary, there only you can use it. Now drones have come. Drone application is a very handy, and also localized application, you can do it. Suppose in a plot of 100 acres, there will be 20 farmers. Even sometimes there is pest in 10 farmers' lands. 5 will apply, 5 won't apply, again it will spread. Now we can do coordinated effort with a drone, with government support. Even I told our people, if you can work it out, if it is necessary, we will spend all the money from government side. And also farmers will be relieved for pest management. But they have to associate, if necessary, all money we will spend, you work it out. That is what I told my people. As a pilot, we want to, Rabi, we want to totally. Even we want to use outsourcing of agencies for spraying the pest, everything. And also there are so many value additions. This conference has to give ideas for that. And also there is various markets available, best markets. Even some of the markets, they preferable varieties. That also you have to give ideas. This type of workshops has to do some more brainstorming. If you can give all workable ideas, I am prepared to implement in Andhra Pradesh so that the farmers will have a benefit out of it. On agriculture, it is very nearer to my heart. I was a farmer. I know the pains and suffering of a farmer. That's why I am spending so much of time on agriculture as on today. Even we have, if you see, food habits have changed. So we are also changing strategies. I am concentrating on agriculture. I am focusing more on horticulture, where money is available. And also I am concentrating more on livestock. People are taking more milk and milk products, and also meat and chicken. And also aquaculture, there is a lot of demand. Growth is nearly 40% in aquaculture. Nowhere in the world 40% growth that is possible in Andhra Pradesh. That is how we have focused on aquaculture. These are all the areas we are working together today. I am very happy to be here. This conclave has to give new ideas where we can improve our varieties. Not only that, ultimately, I want to reach the best in the country. Ultimately, I wanted to compete the best in the world. China is doing, why can't we do? Or some other country is doing some other commodity, why can't we do? That is the spirit, I want to take it up. Now technology has become a handy. Even scientist has to keep it in mind. Information technology, thanks to information technology, world has become a global village. Today, we are one step ahead. If you see today, technology and Internet of Things. By sitting here, you can inspect any field. And also you can watch real-time virtual inspection how fields are through drones. Biometrics has come, drones have come, even surveillance cameras have come. Even cell phone is enough to take geotagging and crop pattern and send it real time. Even machine learning has come. If you put all the crop geotagging maps or photos, even machine learning you can analyze which area, which plot, or which district, which mandal, there is a prevalence of a pest or which is going to have a problem in the near future also. There is a historical data. Data can be collected right away. Wind speed, wind direction, and also satellite data. Everything is available now. Only all this data we have to analyze. Even analytical tools are available. Only the problem, how to use this data, how to analyze all these things, how to put it for action plan is very, very important. Where I have to execute it. And also I have to get outcomes. It will be useful for writing books. Somebody may follow, somebody may not follow. It may be useful, it may not be useful. If you apply this knowledge and get outcomes out of it, then it is a reality. Then only it is beneficial. So we are all in that direction. I am very happy to be here. I wish all the best. Again, I am saying to you, all of you, what all you are going to give ideas, this Rabi I am going to implement, and also on the basis of further improvement I am going to do in Kharif. Either technology penetration or technology adoption or best practices, best varieties, what all your ideas we are going to implement. And also, our farmers will appreciate you also for your best ideas and good ideas. With this, I wish all the best.
Thank you, sir. I think the state is really fortunate to have a vision who believes in action.
Our Vice Chancellor has said one thing, model farms. We had some campaign modes also. One is Polam Pilustundi. Every day, Monday, Tuesday, last second?
Yes.
Every Tuesday? Tuesday and Wednesday, all our people are going to the field. There we have organized some model farms. As you rightly mentioned, now we have to demonstrate model farms continuously at state level, district level, mandal level, village level. Continuously, you have to take farmers for exchange of ideas. Visits, you have to continuously have to make it into a routine, it is a cycle you have to organize, then only that knowledge will come. Support also. Best fields, state level, district level, we will support. And also, we will make our people also, even agriculture university and others. And also, you bring, I don't know, as on today, highest yield anywhere in the state, what is the highest yield? Commissioner? 9,000. It is better than China. Better, more than China, I mean, Nellore's are for the land, after the tea. China is 8,000 average. That means 30,000 to 40,000. Yours is 5,000 average. It is 9,000 highest. China 8,000 average, highest may be 15,000. You have to understand that. So we have to, with these vice chancellors, all these people are becoming traditional. That is the problem. 10,000, 15,000 China, best form, you showcase, get it that productivity, then I will appreciate it.
Yes. Data on the day. Yes.